Yo, what's up? It's your favorite YouTuber, Chatrid Hayes, here on the camera phone on my phone. Anyway, I was sitting around thinking, I wish I had my camera, but I'm going to put this out anyway, but I was sitting around thinking about kids and stuff, particularly my stepdaughter, you know, which, you know, my daughter too, you know. I married her mom, so they made her my daughter. So, anyway, I was thinking, we had a conversation the other week. Actually, me and my stepdaughter had a few words for the very first time ever. She's 17, so you know how teenagers are. And we kind of got into it a little bit, you know. But we end up, had some words, you know. But we got an understanding afterward. We talked it out. But the thing was, you know, I was trying to tell her about herself, about some things she needed to step up and start doing. Because, you know, next year, she's leaving the supposedly go to the military, you know. That's what she said she want to do, you know. Hopefully, you know, she get to do what she want to do. But like I was saying, it was some things that, you know, me and her, we had bumped heads a little bit. So it was cool. And I'm glad it happened because it needed to have happened. Yes, I'm going to post this on YouTube, my wife. And I'm going to share it on Facebook. And somebody, hopefully, somebody going to see this. Somebody who needs to see this and hear this. But it's like this with me. You know, it was a long time before I had any children. You know, everybody know Chad didn't have no kids. You know, I got married again and everything. And I got two biological kids, which are three years old and seven, a little girl and a little boy. You know, and I love all the kids' ages, which is my stepdaughter, my daughter. Still, you know, people don't like, don't say stepdaughter. But, hey, the government said she, once I married her mama, she became a stepdaughter. So that's what the government said. That's what it is. But anyway, it don't matter, you know. I'm going to take care of her just the way I'm going to take care of the other little two ones, the other two, you know, because, you know, that's what I'm supposed to do. I'm their parent, one of their parents, you know. But anyway, getting to the thing, like I said, we had a little blowout and she said some things and I had to catch myself because I don't want to lose, especially on a child, nobody child. You know, even though she's in my house, I've been around me since 2013. Yeah, that when Jonathan was born. Yeah, so she's been around me since 2013. So, and the whole time that we've been around each other, you know, I done met, like, her daddy, parents, a sibling, yeah, her auntie, her daddy's sister, and I met her daddy, her granddad, with my stepdaughter, granddad, grandmother, and great-grandmother. Yeah, I'm saying it right. And her auntie on her dad's side of the family. But I never, well, I'd have seen him, her dad, once. But I didn't know who he was the first time I seen him. Well, I ain't seen him once, but I know who he is. I know what he looked like. But I seen him, and at the time, I didn't know that was him. Because we had never got introduced or met, which is crazy. I'd have met his wife. I think that's his wife, because she didn't, you know, been to where we used to live, age up before. But the point that I'm getting to is that, look at, and I ain't gonna call your name out or nothing like that, but hopefully you get the message and you see this video. I don't know why that you had never just came around. I mean, you ain't never met and just talked or chopped it up. And no reason, you know what I'm saying? Ain't no reason that we couldn't have, because age is your daughter. And I hope that you ain't never felt like that. Maybe, you know, you couldn't come where I'm at or whatever. But that's your daughter. And any time that you need to see your daughter, wanna come through and holler at your daughter and we home, whatever, come through, you know. But the point that I'm getting to, I know y'all ain't got a relationship like a father and daughter should have. And, you know, and I know the bond that I have with my little ones and my little girl and my little boy, I understand that it's a bond that come from birth. If you love and you have it come from the before birth. Because if you dare, I know I'm blundering and rambling, y'all, so bear with me. If you have a child, being conceived or born through that process, and got love in your heart for them, of course you got unconditional love before they're born, and then I know you're gonna have should have unconditional love once they get here. That's what I'm trying to get said about that. But you know, sometimes your kid needs you. It ain't about the finances. Never think that. You know, you do your part. You pay your child support. If you got a child with someone, it's for anybody. You know, you do your part. But at the end of the day, that child needs you around. And I ain't trying to call you out, bro, and saying you ain't never been around and been there, but you ain't been there enough. And I ain't trying to shit on nobody. I'm not. Your daughter needs you. I can't give her that feeling that you should be giving her. The feeling that, it's a feeling that you can't explain. Like I said, it's an unconditional feeling that you feel for your bloodline, your child. It's just like, if they hear, they create, they come through, you be like, you know, it's like, for me, it's like a feeling that you can't get nowhere else. You know what I'm saying? Nothing in the world can no matter money, no matter what you've done, it's like a great feeling. So I'm assuming that you had that great feeling. I had that great feeling for you, your children that in your household, and the children that you may not have in the household. That's what I'm saying, just in general. But man, my thing is, you got a child in this world, and you got a heart, and you care anything. Don't let nothing keep you from being in their life the way you should. Not saying that, you know, because I know when you're not living inside the household with the family, with your kids or whatever, it's different and it's difficult. And sometimes it becomes difficult relationships and different problems and different issues. When, you know, sometimes, you know, people don't get along or something. But if you can get along and everything, make sure that you're getting your kid life, man. Because next year, this time, she'll be graduating from high school and she's planning on going off to the military or whatever she planning on doing. She could change her mind. I don't know. But this message is for you, bro. I don't know you. We should know each other. You should want to know me. You should want to know the man that's in your daughter's life, that's living under the same roof as your daughter. You should know about me. I would want to know about any man. Just said me and Marquita don't make it, and our relationship fail, and we get divorced or separated. You know what I want? I want whoever that's in that household with my child, that she may be with again, if she with somebody, if something ever happens to us. But I want whoever she is, she with somebody or whatever, to know that, hey, I'm being part of my child's life. I ain't got no issues about what y'all doing or whatever. But as long as my kid safe and whatever, and you respectful to my child, then fine. You know, and they respectful towards you, great. But at the same time, we need. I'm sorry, I'm at the school, y'all. I'm kind of watching and looking around for Jonathan while I come out the door and stuff and everything. I'm looking away, I'm looking. But I'm trying to watch, make sure I ain't about to run over nobody. But anyway, YouTube, this is one of Chad Talks again, but it's real talk, it always real talk. But you know what I'm saying? You got to be out here in your kid's life, man. Because it leaves a void in their spirit and their soul. And they be looking for something out here in this world that they can't get. But hold tight, y'all. Hey!